Hello friends, welcome to Fidus in Rio. This is our first video, our introduction video on the internet. Fidus in Rio is a so-called Budo discipline. Our main martial art what we practice is Aikido Jutsu, Jujutsu Traditional and Juno Kenpo. We take a walk to our dojo and today you see two of my advanced students practice and have some fun. Yummy! First of all, I'd like to introduce myself. My name is Ron den Boer. This is Leon Vader Sensei. And this is Remco Palte Sensei. Before we continue our video, I like to say right up front that with this video, it's not our intention to discredit or disrespect any other martial art or Budo. What you're seeing today is just the way we see it and how we practice it in our dojo. We hope you're gonna like it and have a lot of fun. Thank you very much and domo arigato. Welcome to our first video in Fidus in Rio. Today, we want to show you and to explain to you the importance of Atemi, Atemi Waza. What is Atemi Waza? Atemi Waza is the Japanese word for striking and kicking to vulnerable parts of the attacker. We're going to show you some different types of Atemi, so you have an idea what we practice in our system. For example, we can use our head, a headbutt. We can use elbows on the side of the head, upcoming elbow on the plexus. We can use our hands, for example, a shuto, striking in the neck. We can strike in the ribs. Then we have tetsu, that's hammer fist, on the temple, on the nose. Then we have a palm strike on the plexus, on the side of the head. We have a muscle on the throat. And then, of course, we can use our legs. For example, we can use a low kick. We can use an attack to the knee, to the groin, and on very close distance, we can use our knee to the plexus or the head. These are our most important ways how we practice Atemi. From beginning level to advanced level, it always is one of the important parts how we train it. Especially Fidus in Rio, because you are joint lock orientated, we are grappling orientated. So Atemi is one of the most important things what we can do. We're going to show you two examples. First attack is what we call a typical dojo attack. There is no aggression. There is no resistance. There is only cooperation. And that's fine. But in a real situation, we're going to show you, you need different tools. First of all, we go to the first part. And that is the part of no resistance. This is what you quite often see in many, many martial arts that is using joint locks. For example, Aikido, Aikido Jiu-Jitsu, traditional Jiu-Jitsu, or yeah, whatever. Most of the practicing systems who use this knows exactly what I mean. For example, this is the not resistance part. You can see. What you see is that the attacker, in this case, Remco, is not using any force, any resistance, any power whatsoever. A matter of fact, Leon can use any technique he wants, any technique he wants to practice, because there is no resistance. Can you show it once again, please? No resistance. So you see? For example, now come Sankyo. Now we're going to show you the second part. And that's the part when the attacker is using much resistance, much force, much aggression. Once again, and you see the difference immediately. You see, Leon tried to do anything to get the wrist or do his movement. It's not going to work. Only he resists. He's fighting back. So when you talk about Atemi, then you can understand, we're going to show you how important Atemi is. We're going to show you the same movement with a lot of resistance, a lot of fighting back from Remco. And then you're going to see what's happening with the Atemi. Please, show. Fantastic. If you watch it slowly, with the same aggression, this was happening. There was a lot of resistance here, a lot of power, you see? He cannot get the wrist, it's not possible. He has to use Atemi. In this case, he hit him full force on the throat. Immediately result. And then he can use his techniques. In this case, Sankyo, Sankyo Nage. This is very, very important. Without the Atemi, and in a real self-defense situation, it's not going to work. You see, the first one, he tried it, it doesn't work. It's normal, there is too much resistance. The second one, he used the Atemi. If you talk about Atemi, we have different kinds what we're showing you in the earlier footage. For example, the same attack. He can use many kinds of Atemis. Yes. So now you understand. And it's very clear to see the part without Atemi and the part with Atemi. Please remember, try to do it carefully. You can cooperate it in your own self-defense system or your own martial art. But be careful, please. But use it on a very safe way. I also like to mention that I'm very, very sorry for my horrible English. I'm very, very sorry. I try to improve it. And you're going to see next time, I hope, it's going to be a little better, my English language. Please give comments about it, requests, or whatever you want to tell to us. Please be free to contact us. Our website, www.fudoshinryu.nl. I'd like to thank Remco Palter-sensei, Leon Vader-sensei, and behalf of myself, domo arigato, and we hope to see you next time.